And so the last talk in the session is a presentation of a platform for evaluation, implementation, and generation of S boxes. The paper is by Zhenzhen Bao, Jian Guo, Sang Li, and Yu Sasaki, and Zhenzhen Bao will give the talk.
Thanks for the introduction. So I would like to introduce our SOK paper on the design of S-box and a platform for evaluation, implementation, and generation of S-box. So many block ciphers follow the Shannon idea, sequentially application of the confusion and diffusion. Confusion are generally provided by the form of substitution box, so S-box for short. The natural question is how to distinguish the good S-box from the bad S-box. So developed for the several decades, the design criteria on S-box have been involved, and both for the security respect and the implementation performance aspect. So in this talk, in this paper, we aim to provide a survey on the known results on the design criteria of S-box, and also build a platform for assist the evaluation, implementation, and generation of S-box. And I will introduce the three aspects of functionality of S-box, and would like to use the light, the green ball, to indicate that PEIGEN can provide the functionality efficiently, and use the yellow ball to indicate that PEIGEN is only efficient for small S-box, and use the red ball to indicate the corresponding functionality is currently not supported by PEIGEN currently. So S-box, an S-box mapping NB to M bits will have M coordinates, and they are the N variable Boolean function. We denote them use SEI. There are many ways to represent an S-box. The direct way is use the lookup table. And also there is a bit slice representation. And they are the concatenate of the value vector of the coordinates. So both of the representation can be accepted as input to PEIGEN. Besides, there is also mathematical representation. A general conventional way is use the algebraic normal form. So use this formula. Given the value vector of the Boolean function, we can compute the efficiently the algebraic normal form. So given the bit slice representation of an S-box, PEIGEN will output the algebraic normal form of the coordinate. So we want to make a distinguish between the coordinates and the components of the S-box, because some property can only be defined use the components. The components are the linear combination of the coordinates. We say an S-box is balanced if they take every value the same number of times. So if all of the components are balanced Boolean function, the S-box is balanced. The balanced S-box mapping NB to NBit are of particular interest. They are the permutation. So let's look into the security aspect. With respect to the resistance to differential cryptanalysis, the property of the derivative of the S-box can provide some quantify the strength of the S-box. So the solution of the derivative equation can be formed into this well-known difference distribution table. And PEIGEN will compute the maximum in this table. And this is the well known as the differential uniformity. Our community are still seeking for larger S-box with even dimensional because they are good for the resistance to differential analysis. So besides the maximum, the frequency of the maximum occurs in this DDT, and also the frequency of the values in this table may also provide distinguish between S-box with the same uniformity because they can behave differently for specific cipher and provide more accurate upper bound for the, for example, two round of the upper bound on the maximum expected differential probability of the cipher, for example, for AES. So PEIGEN will compute the frequency, the differential spectrum, and for the resistance to linear crypts analysis, the property of the Walsh transform and the Walsh coefficients are important criteria. And they are related, the Walsh coefficient is related with the bears of the linear approximation. So we call this the table formed by the coefficient, Walsh coefficient, say as the linear approximation table. And again, the maximum in this, the maximum in this table, the absolute value, is defined as the linearity, and there we also desire S-box with small linearity. And again, the frequency of the maximum occurs in this table, and the whole Walsh spectrum can also provide distinguish between S-box with the same linearity. So given an S-box, PEIGEN will evaluate the spectrum, the Walsh spectrum. For some cipher, their linear layer only consists of bit permutation. So the S-box require not only provide some confusion, but also some diffusion. So the differential branch number and the linear branch number may be the criteria for the design. So now we focus on the subtable in the DDT and the LET. They are named the DDT1 and LET1. And so the maximum in those subtables and also the number of non-zero entries in these subtables are of significance for some cipher. So PEIGEN will output the difference distribution in this form. It will rearrange the rows and the columns so that they are in the Hamming weight order, so that we can clearly see the DDT in the right in the left upper corner, and also output the uniformity and the spectrum when see the subtables. So for an S-box can be completely specified by the linear approximation table. So it's possible to recover the S-box from the LET. And also from some good DDT, we may recover some DDT equivalence class of S-box. However, this functionality is currently not supported by PEIGEN. So as mentioned by yesterday's talk, the resistance to boomerang attack may be related with the boomerang connectivity table. And again, there is a boomerang uniformity, the boomerang differential spectrum that may interest for evaluate. So PEIGEN will compute this BCT. And for the resistance to algebraic attack, the maximum among the degrees of all components and the minimum among the degree of the components may be important. So besides the frequency of the degree may important, so PEIGEN will compute the maximum degree, the minimum degree, and the degree spectrum according to the ANF of the components of the S-box. So besides the linear, the degree of the linear combination of the coordinates, the product of the degree, the maximum degree of the product of k coordinates can also useful because they may be used to in the division property based tag, and for given an S-box, PEIGEN will evaluate this DK and output a table like this. Besides, this DK can also provide some accurate, more accurate estimation for the degree of the whole cipher according to this theorem. So besides DK, which is related with the division property based integral attack, there is another notion, the site, which shows the appearance of monomials in the ANF of the product of the coordinates of S-box can be important because they may show some resistance of the S-box against the division property-based attack. So PEIGEN will evaluate the table representation of this table. And for besides the algebraic normal form, which is a multivariant polynomial representation, the S-box can also be uniquely represented by the univariant polynomial. The univariant degree and the number of terms in the univariant polynomial representation may be important, but currently PEIGEN do not evaluate. And for the resistance to truncated differential and the subspace trio attack, the linear structure of the S-box may be important because when you evaluate the longest subspace trio, if the S-box have linear structure, we should consider this. Besides, the linear structure of the Boolean function is actually a very early notion to provide a measurement on the linearity of the Boolean function. And the linear structure of the S-box has been used in very early differential-like attacks on death. Given an S-box, PEIGEN will output the linear structure of the S-box. So there is a efficient way to find all linear structures. Use the autocorrelation table formed by the autocorrelation coefficient of the components of the S-box. So given S-box, PEIGEN will output the autocorrelation table also. For the resistance to some cube-like attack, the notion of VW linearity may be important because it can quantify the ability of the S-box to propagate fine relations. So an S-box is VW linear if there exists two linear subspace, the input subspace V and the output subspace W of dimension small v and W, such that all components of the S-box in this output subspace W are affine on all coset of the input subspace. Given an S-box, PEIGEN will evaluate the VW linearity of the S-box and output a table like this. It shows the number of subspace V of dimension V such that there exists a W dimensional W such that the S-box is VW linear and also output all the subspace VW. And As mentioned by the first first day's talk, the resistance to invariant subspace attack may related to the existence of the nonlinear invariant of the S box, especially the quadratic ones. So maybe it's of interest to evaluate the nonlinear invariant of the S box. But currently, PEIGEN do not support this functionality. So lots of the previous mentioned cryptographic property are invariant under some transformation. For example, the linear transformation, the permutation transformation. And the knowledge on the largest transformation group that preserve criteria is very important to study such criteria, and also to reduce the space of the S-box we should focus on. So given S-box, PEIGEN will evaluate the representative of its permutation XOR equivalence class, and also the representative of the is a linear equivalence class, and test whether two S-box are fan equivalents. And if they are equivalent, it will output fan permutations. However, concept of equivalence are the extended fan equivalence and the CCZ equivalent. However, PEIGEN currently do not evaluate this equivalence. So this previous is on the security aspect. On the implementation aspect, we first provide a survey on existing tools. And through the comparison, we found a tool named Lighter provided by Jian, etc., have the most features, and the speed is acceptable, and they are open code. So we want to build implementation aspect of functionality based on Lighter. So given S-box, PEIGEN will evaluate the implementations good in terms of the following performance criteria: the bit slice gate complexity, the gate equivalence complexity, the multiplicative complexity, and the depth complexity. And inherent from Lighter, PEIGEN can consider that different gate can have different cost, both for the gate equivalence and the gate equivalence complexity and the depth complexity. So the approach in Lighter used the bidirectional Dijkstra's shortest path finding algorithm, and they expand two graphs, from the identity function and the other is the target function, the S-box. And it used meeting the middle strategy to find the implementation of the target. And the nodes are all developed, expanded, use the right-hand left side kind of function. They are invertible. And so based on this approach, we propose some optimization method, because we found these two graphs are actually also isomorphic. And so actually we only need to compute one algorithm, one graph, and which is independent with the target. So by use the composition and concatenation method, we can find the implementation of the target. And because this graph can be pre-compute and stored, so they can be used once for all. So we also use some equivalence between the implementation sequence to reduce the search space, so that PEIGEN is efficient even for given a large set of small S-box. And we want to enrich the functionality by make it cover some larger S-box and support finding the depth optimal implementation. while it's currently only efficient for 3 and 4 bit sbox. And for the generation aspect, we use the simple circuit construction method, which is very similar for the construction method of Lufa, the sbox of Lufa. Actually, it is a direct extension of the implementation functionality. It still uses the pre-compute graph and compose the nodes in the graph to get the composition function. And given a set of criteria, it checks the results whether fulfill such a set of criteria, and also use the invertible small functions. So the two usage of in PEIGEN is that if given a set of criteria together with the set of sbox, it can filter out those sbox fulfilling this criteria and output the more detailed evaluations. And if only given a set of criteria, PEIGEN can generate some sbox, some new sbox fulfilling the given criteria, and classify the result according to their detailed properties. So let's make a summary. In this work, we try to provide a CV on the known result on the design of sbox, and we want to build a platform to assist the evaluation, implementation, and generation of sbox. However, PEIGEN is still missing some functionality, and it's not yet powerful enough for the implementation and generation of strong, larger sbox. So, but we believe there exists a heuristic and a theoretical method that can tackle the larger sbox and integrate into this platform. So for interested readers, we refer to the GitHub website for the source code and all the generate results. Thanks for your attention.
Questions?
Yeah.
Thank you for the talk. Suppose someone wanted to contribute code to this PEIGEN platform. What would be the best way to go about it? Through GitHub or?
Yeah, maybe GitHub.
Okay. Thank you.
Other questions? Yes.
Did you do some benchmarking about the speed of your implementation compared to other open available implementations?
We just implement other tools and try some experiments, and it shows that there are the set-based method, and the set-based method is not very efficient for the implementation. And also there is the depth first search algorithm, and the output is not guaranteed to be optimal, but the speed is compatible with the letter-based method.
And for the security evaluation methods, is it? Did you also do some benchmarking?
Security, no.
So for this computing the differential uniformity and equivalence classes and stuff like this?
You mean the evaluation speed of the tour or the result?
No, say that if I have, I don't know, a large set of S-boxes and I want to pick the best from this set regarding some security notion, maybe for differential uniformity. So did you, and there are, I don't know, for example, SageMath can also do this, and did you compare your implementation speed-wise to the implementation from Sage?
I tried Sage first, but for large set of sbox, Sage does not provide the result efficiently.
Okay, thanks.
And for this tour, we can evaluate to the, for example, 20 or S-box simultaneously efficiently.
Okay.
Any other question?
Well, I have one. So, how hard would it be to add, for example, another design criteria in your tool? Like, is it based on a lot of small modules, and you can add the small module which says, well, I have another criteria for my boxes, and I plug the module, and everything will work correctly? Or do you need to do a bit more technical work in the code to make it work?
I don't know. You mean to evaluate the given S-box?
Yeah.
You can write the truth, the lookup table representation in the file. The PEIGEN will read the file to generate the evaluation.
No, this was more in the other way. Like, imagine that I found some new design criteria for S-boxes.
Code a file named func. This file provides the class, the CPP class, and you can add new functions to this class and to evaluate a new criteria.
Okay, thank you.
Is there any other question? So I think you will get some new contribution to this tool. So thanks very much. Let's thank all speakers of the session. We now have lunch and the next session.